ओम श्री गणेशाय नमः। ओम श्री सरस्वत्यै नमः। ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। ओम समस्त जन कल्याणे निरतं करुणामयं नमामि चिन्मयं देवं सद्गुरुं ब्रह्म विद्वरं। ओम सदा शिव समारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वंदे गुरु परंपरां शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्य कृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं। हरिओम। सो वी सॉ यस्टरडे दैट द एसेंस द प्योर कॉन्शियसनेस द सच्चिदानंद परब्रह्म परमात्मा एग्जिस्टेंस इज वन एंड द सेम। So it is all pervading Vishnu. So in that, everything is superimposed. And because of superimposition, and due to Upadhi Bheda, because of so many Upadhis, there are varieties of conditionings. So truth expressing through different conditionings, through different names and forms, appear as infinite varieties in the creation. Right. So therefore, when upadhis, all these conditionings are reduced or demolished, destroyed, then what remains is one unbroken, homogeneous, all-pervading consciousness. But this is the realization which we have to realize. What is the example given to this? Nearest example in 10th sloka visa, akasha, space. So space is conditioned by different walls. We give them different names, room space, etc., etc., kitchen space, etc., bedroom, etc. And we measure between the walls. And we say the space in the room is this much is the area of space. All these are all only existing from the standpoint of upadhis, walls. From the standpoint of space, it cannot be broken. It is undivided. So in space, everything is superimposed. Due to upadhis, the one akasha appearing as many, with many names, many conditionings. So this truth we have to realize. So when me or you or anyone for that matter, when we free our consciousness from the shackles of the upadhi, by the grace of Shastra, Guru, Shastra and Ishwara. Because of, by the grace of these three, when we rediscover, when we discover that we are not this complex, upadhi complex, but we are consciousness freed from matter. This is a practical experience. It's an experience of Mahatmas. They disassociated themselves with upadhi and they discovered their I. So far, I means, for us, I means body or mind or prana, etc. For the awakened souls, awakened beings, they awaken to a new dimension of consciousness. Therefore, the meaning of I for them is different. I is consciousness. And they become aware that I am actually freed from all these upadhis. I am that unconditioned, all-pervading I, soaked in Brahman, rooted in Brahman. I am Brahman. So this is experience. So what is the marga for that? We have seen in the beginning itself. Vedanta says about that marga is only jnana marga. So to get eligibility for knowledge. Knowledge means here understanding. To get that eligibility for that knowledge, what we must do is prepare our mind and intellect. So preparation or preparing the mind and intellect will go on for lives, not in one life. Because each negativity, each thing has to be conquered. This is what Bhagavan Krishna said, Bahunam Janmanam Ante. At the end of many lives of spiritual journey. Here Gurudev puts a very beautiful start statement that don't again count that Bahunam Janmanam, many lives from this life. Maybe already you have lived in spiritual sadhana for many lives. Maybe it is last. So with that feeling and inspiration, work out your evolution. This is how beautifully Gurudev said. So same thought is continued. How on one Chaitanyam, how different kinds of upadhis are formed, superimposed, and how the same truth is expressing and how we mistaken it. So here, friends, remember, two adhyastas are there, superimpositions. One problem, one superimposition is that on that Brahma Vastu, infinite consciousness, both sentient and insentient things are superimposed. Chetana Vastu, Achetana Padartha, both are superimposed. How Chetana is superimposed? Through Chidabhasa. So Chidabhasa as a reflection of the consciousness, it superimposes on the Supreme Brahman, Chidabhasa, and as I, expressing as Jiva. Insentient is Padarthas, various things and various Vastus are all superimposed, matter and spirit, I. Both our expressions are superimposed on Brahman. This is one thing. The subsequent superimposition. Confusion. What is real? What is unreal? The confusion is second superimposition, adhyastha. What kind of confusions we create on ourselves? Like the first superimposition. Suppose body, mind, intellect are superimposed on Brahman. Okay. But second is, forgetting that I am that Brahman, I consider myself as body, mind, intellect complex. That is second step of this problem of superimposition. So see, merely superimposed, okay. If there is no confusion even after superimposition, there is no harm in it. Okay, it's a nature's play. But what is the problem is, the superimposed is considered as I, me, and this is creating the problems. So I forgot myself, who am I? And I have been identified with the body, mind, intellect, and this is the problem. So what is the truth now? How one truth is misunderstood as different names and forms due to superimposition of upadhis is being told now by Shankaracharya. That's what the topic is going on. So we'll continue 11th verse. Nanopadhivashadeva नानोपाधिवशादेव जातिवर्णाश्रमादयः जातिवर्णाश्रमादयः आत्मन्यारोपितास्तो ये आत्मन्यारोपितास्तो ये रसवर्णादिभेदवत् रसवर्णादि भेदवत. सो व्हाट इज द ट्रूथ? एकम सत् विप्राः बहुधा वदन्ति. ट्रूथ इज वन, सेजेस कॉल इट बाय मेनी नेम्स बिकॉज ऑफ मेनी एक्सप्रेशंस. बट हियर इट इज सेज नाना उपाधि वशात एव. व्हाट इज उपाधि? नो अंडरस्टैंड, प्लीज लिसन. उपाधि मीन्स व्हाट? Giver of its attributes to something. Upadhi means something is giving its attributes, qualities to someone. In these three conditions are required. Upadhi. That upadhi, meaning that conditioning, the giver, not the receiver. Receiver is called upahitam. Upahitam. And the giver is called upadhi. So this upadhi, first condition is, it should be nearer to the object to which it is lending its attributes or qualities. Upa samipe. So upadhi cannot be far, so it should be nearer, number one. Number two, it should lend its properties, give its properties to the upahitam, the vastu to which it is nearby. It should give its properties, it should give. Number three, this giving is not real, it is apparent. Three things important. First one, should be nearer. It should give its properties, qualities to the vastu to which it is nearby. And this giving is not real, it is apparent. These three to be remembered. Upadhi means. So, if you get a crystal and a flower, so what is the crystal? Upahitam. What is the flower? Upadhi. When the red hibiscus flower brought close to the crystal, then what happens is, first one is, condition is proved. You can tick it. It is nearer to the crystal, number one. Number two, the qualities of that is that color is check here, red color attributes of the flower. It is giving that attribute to the crystal. And third is, this giving red color to the crystal, this transfer is not real, it is only apparent. Three things are noticed. So, therefore, in the presence of that red flower, the crystal becomes red. If the transfer is real and permanent, then the problem, you can never become pure again. Luckily, the transfer is not real. So it superimposes its qualities on, redness on the crystal. So the crystal has actually not lost its pristine purity, but appears to be so on account of upadhi. So upadhi dharma is like that. So that upadhi dharma, what kind of dharmas are superimposed on atma? Whatever upadhi dharma is there, that is superimposed, temporarily transferred, apparently transferred onto me. What kind of things are there? So one is, from the point of space, he said all the walls are conditioned by this wall, the space conditioned by the walls, example we saw in the previous sloka. Now he says, jati, varna, ashrama, adayaha, etc. I am dhani, I am brahmana jati, vaishya jati, sudra jati, kshatriya jati. Or I can say varna, brahmacharya, sorry, the brahmana, kshatriya. Jati is again, the various jatis are there. And varna is also brahmana, varmana, kshatriya, sudra, varna. And within brahmana, there are so many jatis are there. So many branches are there. In which brahmana, varna only special jatis are there, special surnames are there. All these are all actually not belonging to me. They are all superimposed on me. Atmani aropitaha. They are all superimposed. But I know one thing we want to know, we have to analyze ourselves, that how much we are identified with these things. And the prestige born out of identification. False prestige. We become egoistic. Adayaha, I am a rich man. I could be egoistic because of my richness. Well educated. Another upadhi. So all these things, whatever I am really not, are considered to be me, to be mine, to be me really, is only because of ignorance. So therefore, Vivek Shramani sloka comes in meditation sloka. Jati niti kula gotra duragam. Nama rupa guna dosha varjitam desha kala vishayati vartiyate brahma tattva masi bhavayatmani. Beautiful meditative slokas. So jati, niti, kula, gotra, duragam. I am far away from all this. Desha kala vishayati vartiyate. I am beyond despe. Space, time and causation, vastu. And what I am then? Brahma tattva masi bhavayatmani. I am that eternal, pure. Therefore, Shankaracharya wrote the Brahma Jnanavalli असंगोहम 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 पुनः पुनः सच्चिदानंद रूपोहम अहमेवाहमौ। Reinforcing that again and again on the seat of meditation. Otherwise, this creates so much of karma. We get caught up in the web of karma. And to clean this karma, it takes lives. Therefore, all these things are superimposed on me. Therefore, there is no question of superiority complex, inferiority complex. When Ashtavakra came to Janaka's court, everybody laughed. Then Ashtavakra said to Janaka, your court is full of cobblers, charmakaras, those whose drushti is only on the form of my physical body. They are not risen above. So our drushti also should be on. Everywhere, everyone we see, it should flash in our mind, in us, that is nothing but pure consciousness, same consciousness, in the disguise of that particular form, the particular quality. Essentially, everyone is divine. The thought should flash in us. And this is a great sadhana. Essentially, we are divine. An example is given. Toye rasavarnadi bhedavat. It's a beautiful thing. Actually, water is colorless. Water is actually not water, its own taste, but we don't say specific taste. It is neither sweet, nor hot, nor sour. In that water, you add color. Color of school drinks, you know, of different colored waters. And different things you add. So this is a red color, that is a green color, that is yellow, orange drink. But water is pure. Water is actually not all these colors. They are only superimposed. They are only added. Similarly, all these are only added, but my nature is pure water, like pure consciousness. So therefore, Shankaracharya is giving us that is upadhi bheda only, one Atman is appearing. So what should be the consequences of this wisdom in us? As I told you, that you know, our identification with this body, kula, gotra, jati, and so many complications because of that, prestige issues, superiority complex, hatred. See, if you accept some jati as yours, or some varna as yours, as you, how many problems will come? Harmony will be lost. I cannot see divinity anywhere. I will see somebody low, somebody high. I will fight with everyone. My prestige issue comes into picture. Comparison takes place. Groupism takes place. One group stands against other groups. Identified with the body color also, different groups are formed in the world. We are of this color, you are of that color, you are skin color. Groups based on humanity divided based on skin color. How tragedy it is, what a tragedy it is. Humanity divided based on the geographical location. Or jati, gotra, kula, etc. So unless we drop from our mind all these things and see humanity as one, animals also the same consciousness, when I see that uniqueness and oneness everywhere, then alone I will be able to transcend my body limitations. Now, 12, 13, 14 verses speak about sthula, sukshma, karana, sharira, gross body, subtle body, and causal body. 12, 13, 14 verses. Now, jiva is there, and I am not yet awakened to the truth. I am experiencing various karma phalas. Because the body is there, I am going through so many fears, delusions. And you know, one Mahatma told me, we were discussing about it. It's a very beautiful point he mentioned. He said, whether you know, you have a knowledge or not, theoretical knowledge, gained knowledge, not yet awakened. Maya continues to delude you. And the greatness of Maya, he says, knowingly you will fall prey to it. He says, I know this is delusion. I know this is all Maya. I know this is all rubbish. Yet, knowingly you fall prey to it. That is the power of Maya. Knowing means intellectually, you know. You are not awakened yet. Like for example, smoking is injurious to health. Ask someone, Bhaiya, kyun pee rahe ho? Don't you know that smoking is injurious to health? Yes, injurious to health. I know, you don't have to tell me. I got a PhD on the effects of tobacco. I'm a doctorate in it. If you want, I can email my entire report, project study. But why are you drinking? I'm also an advisor to the government of India. Health advisor. So everything is there, knowledge is there. Yet I can't give up my smoking. That is power of Maya. Narad ji ke saath kya hua? Bhagwan Krishna made him go through the entire hell. संसारी बना दिया उनको. स्टोरी यू नो. देयरफॉर बिकॉज वी आर नॉट अवेकेंड स्टिल वी फील दैट दिस इज ऑल एग्जिस्टिंग. दिस इज मी, दिस इज मी, दिस इज मी. दैट्स व्हाई वी से पैरट एग्जांपल इज गिवन. सो डोंट सिंग लाइक अ पैरट. ऑल ऑफ अस आर स्टडीइंग. It's very good. But we must also have a desire that one day means my goal is to, Gurudev says, shut up and get out. What do you mean, shut up and get out? He says, shut your BMI and get out of this complex and realize that you are free. You are not the body. Get out of it, he used to say. I mean, not die. Get out of the identification. Be free, become free. So he was a yogi. Vedanti. That should be our goal. In one day, my goal is, not in one day, someday, my goal is this. Not to tick our books, how many books have I completed, how many textbooks I have studied. This is another maya. So 12, 13, 14 speaks about these conditionings, how we are affected bodily, sukshma, sthula, gross, sukshma, subtle, and karana, causal bodies. What are they? 12th verse we will see. Panchikruta mahabhuta sambhavam karma sanchitam. Panchikruta mahabhuta sambhavam karma sanchitam. Shariram sukadukkhanam. Shariram sukadukkhanam. Bhogayatanamuchyate. Bhogayatanamuchyate. Now see, how the body, what about the body is now? Very simple. This is the body first superimposition, grosser superimposition, body, physical body. What is physical body? Most of you have studied Tattva Bodha. But I will just briefly tell here. Panchikruta Mahabhuta Sambhavam. This is born out of, made out of physical body, created out of five different materials. Those materials, after undergoing a process called panchikaranam, mixture. So all the brahmandas, all the entire creation, is made up of the building blocks of the physical universe is only five. In all lokas, panchamahabhutas only. What are they? Space, air, fire, water, and earth. These five principles are there, matter, elements. So they exist in their purest form. So pure space, pure air, pure fire, pure water, pure earth. Tanmatra, we said tanmatra, that and that alone. Meaning space alone without the mixture of other four. Air alone without the mixture of other four. Like that. So pure space, pure air, etc. they exist. Since they are in purest form, at the purest form level, we cannot see it. Our sense organs cannot perceive. They don't exist. Exist means to us they don't exist because it cannot be seen by sense organs. Now that panchikrutam will take place. The five elements, they are mixed. So in space, with some proportion, 1 by 8, 1 by 8, 1 by 8, 1 by 8. So half space. In the space, half space is separated. And rest 4, 1 by 8, 1 by 8, 1 by 8 of air, 1 by 8 of fire, 1 by 8 of water, 1 by 8 of earth element are collected. So 1 by 8 plus 1 by 8 plus 1 by 8 plus 1 by 8 is 2, half, 1 by 2. Plus half space may half space mixed. And this becomes Akasha, Panchikruta Akasha, that Akasha which we are able to infer. That is a space is created. So in the space, 50% only space is there, Tattva, Akasha Tattva. Other elements 1 by 8, 1 by 8, 1 by 8, 1 by 8 is other 4. Similarly, in Vayu, 50% of air, other 4 are 1 by 8, 1 by 8, 1 by 8, 1 by 8. Like that, all these five elements are mixed. We mix it, no? When ghar bana samay, we mix our cement, sand, water. Then iron also is used. So we mix it. So now, all the lokas are made up of panch tanmatras only, but the proportions are different. Mixture proportions are different formulas. So varieties of universes are created, lokas are created. So in our physical body, there is a formula. I told you formula: 1/8, 1/8, 1/8, 1/8, 1/8 plus 1/2. Main element. So that becomes that element. So this body is made out of panchamahabhutas having undergone the process of panchikarana. So after that mixture is formed, out of that mixture again the body is formed. And what is the, who is the nimitta for this body? Sambhavam. How it is born? Karma sanchitam. Sanchitam means what? It is made out of, assembled out of, influenced by karma. So whether you like it or not, the body and our physical bodies are exactly under the influence of karma. Whether you like it or not, sukham and dukkham comes, arrives on the body. So it is affecting the karma affects it. So karma sanchitam, beautiful thing. What is karma? You are determined by past actions. So if you have done a good punya karma, you will have a good physical body. So many varieties of karmas you do. So the, accordingly the body is given to you. Karma sanchitam. Then shariram sukha dukkhanam bhoga ayatanam uchyate. And it is called bhoga ayatanam. Shelter, a place, house, tenantment, a house where you stay there and experience, a place to sit and go through all the karmic experiences, good and bad. Sukha dukkhanam bhoga ayatanam uchyate. So what is the sharira is? Sharira is nothing but bhogayatanam, meaning it's a shelter. Who is experiencing that will next come, will come. Next verse it will come. But where is the shelter where I can sit quietly and enjoy or suffer? So body is. So a lot of karma manifests on body. One more thing I tell you. Suppose there is a wound on the body because of karma. Some karma ripened and manifested as wound, a big abscess on the hand. Suddenly it protruded and then you ignored, and then ignoring also karma only, buddhi karma anusarini. So you ignored and ultimately became big abscess. That karma was not there, suppose you would have got a good buddhi, go to doctor and immediately treat it in the beginning. So then you would have avoided it. The karma is good. Buddhi hi karma anusarane. So your buddhi, bhogne ki buddhi hai. Bhogne ki, bhogne ka hai. Karma bhogne ka. Isliye buddhi mein aisa vichar bhi nahi aaya. To go and get checked. So it became big abscess. Now see. When abscess is formed, heavy suffering is there. Did you inquire who is suffering? Is body suffering? Body says, I am suffering. Gurudev always used to make us think. Has ever this body, physical body said, I am sick? As this body has ever said to you all, I am diabetic, I am not well? No. Body is only shelter. Ayatanam, support. But who is suffering inside? Mind, subtle body. Subtle body is suffering. Therefore, when you declutch the mind from the pain, there is no pain in the mind. In this deep sleep state, no. But pain you have to suffer, so it manifests on the physical body. And therefore, next verse is beautifully says, bhoga sadhanam is sukshma sharira. Bhoga ayatanam is sthula sharira. Bhoga sadhanam is sukshma sharira. So therefore, one master used to say, great master used to say, the body is the cheapest material on which karma can be exhausted. A yogi he was. Body is the cheapest material on which karma can be easily exhausted. Meaning, let the karma effect be seen on the body, not on the mind. He would say, mind is more precious. Mind is protected, mind is happy, mind is peaceful, body is suffering. The karma is manifesting on the body, it is good. Let it go on, let it go. Some yogi drishti, the view of a yogi. So therefore, sola shariram is bhoga ayatanam, a shelter where we come, and it is a place where we exist, we sit together, and we sit and each one individually suffers or enjoys his own karma. Okay. Now what is sukshma shariram? So sola sharira made up of panchikurta pancha mahabhutas after the mixture process. What out of sukshma sharira? Pancha pranamano buddhihi dashendriya samanvitam apanchikruta bhutottam sukshmangam bhoga sadhanam pancha pranamano buddhihi dashendriya samanvitam apanchikruta bhutottam sukshmangam bhoga sadhanam. Now what is that sukshma sharira comprises is said in this sloka. Pancha pranaha manaha buddhihi dasha indriyani samanvitam. So saptadasha kalabihi, the 17 elements are there in sukshma sharira. In tattvabodha it comes, what are they? Jnanendriyas 5, karmendriyas, panchapranas, manaha and buddhi. These 17 forms the sukshma sharira, subtle body. Therefore, after leaving the body also, sukshma sharira may, all these sense organs are there, jnanendriyas are there, karmendriyas are there, mind is there. That's why mind alone is a torturer. Mind haunts us. So mind is there, buddhi is there, pancha pranas are there. So everything, he leaves the kit and goes. This is sukshma sharira, dashendriya samanvitam. So this is the, so what does it do? This sukshma sharira, pancha pranas, you know, prana, apana, vyana, udana, samana, 5 major functions of the physiological functions in the body are taken care by pancha pranas. And there are some more upapranas are there. 5 upapranas are there. Each prana is responsible for a typical function of the physical body. The details are all, we need not see into it. So there are so many pranas are there, pancha pranas, they are different functions they do. And you know, jnanendriyas 5. Eyes, ears, nose, tongue, skin. Jnanendriyas. Karmendriyas, hands, legs, speech, anus and genital organs. Karmendriyas. Through which action is done. Jnanendriyas, knowledge is gained through sense organs. 5 sense organs. So, panchaprana, mind, you know, sankalpa vikalpatmakaha. Mind is full of doubts. Sometime it, so everywhere it is, chanchala, swabhavaha. Buddhi is that which helps us to arrive at a conclusion. All these things are forms subtle body. Apanchikurta bhutottam. They are all made up of pancha tanmatras directly. Not panchikurtam. Not after mixture. So everything is in tattvabodha, you get exhaustive list you will get. What is that which instrument is made? from what panchatanmatras and all those things. Apanchikuta bhutottam sukshma angam. It is called subtle body. Bhoga sadhanam. It is the instrument of experience. Shelter is body. But what is that instrument through which you experience sukha dukkha? Subtle body. So where are indriyas are suffering? Indriyas are, where are the sense organs? In subtle body. They suffer. Mind suffers. Intellect suffers. Or enjoys. Sukham and dukkham. So that is bhoga sadhanam, sukshma shariram. So stola shariram is bhoga ayatanam. Sukshma shariram is bhoga sadhanam. Then what about karana sharira? That we will see tomorrow. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnat Purnamadachate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vasishyate. Om Shantihi Shanti Shantihi. Arihi Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha. Arihi Om Sadgurunath Maharaj Ki Jai. Thank you all. Hari Om.